Ah, interesting. Hi, it's Todd of Todd's Workshop and Todd Cutler here. And today I'm back with a spread of lockdown longbow simulators, £80 through to £160. Gambeson, handmade maille by Isaac Crow, beautiful stuff. Type 16 arrowheads, and sharp, like sharp. What's the difference? Well, much to my shame, especially as a knife maker, I didn't think that making very sharp arrowheads would make that much difference when you're going against flesh or against fabric. But actually, they're the only type of arrowheads we have physical evidence for that had steel in the heads. So that, of course, gets you thinking. And then one of you lot out there, a guy called David Jones, has done some fantastic work. He's written a paper, link in the notes, about the importance of sharp arrowheads against maille and fabric armour. And he said something which gave me a eureka moment. And very simply is, if you make your arrowhead a little bit sharp, it penetrates the fabric. If you make it sharp, it goes straight through the fabric armour. But, of course, if you can blunt the arrowhead, i.e. you put maille on the outside, your arrowhead is going to pass through the maille, get blunted, not go through the fabric armour very well. If you do it the other way round, the arrowhead goes clean through the fabric armour, maille is not that resistant against arrows, and the arrows go through the maille. So actually, you wear your maille on the outside. That, of course, gave me this eureka moment, which is, well, if you can keep your arrowhead sharper as it goes through the maille, stands a better chance of going through the fabric. Is that why they put steel in the heads of these sort of arrowheads? It's a theory, and that's all it is. It's a theory, it's my theory, it's an idea. It is not fact. But it does answer some interesting questions, and that's what we're going to test here. Now, it means that I can't test the maille today because I want to see what the fabric does on its own with these arrowheads. So I'm going to take two layers of the gambeson just to magnify any effects up. I'm going to shoot them as, you know, sort of reasonably sharp munition grade out the forge arrowheads, and then ones which have had considerable care in the sharpening of them. And we're going to see if there's a difference, because if there was a difference, they would have sharpened them up properly. But before we carry on, just very simply, what is this whole lockdown longbow thing? I've been running these films for a year, so some of you aren't familiar with it. If you're not, go back to the first couple of films and hopefully you'll get it. But these bows here shoot at the same speed that medieval longbows did, as far as we know, and they shoot the same weight arrows. The target doesn't care. So I'm just going to put them through the chronograph now so we can just have a look at it, make sure I'm not fibbing, and then we can carry on with the film. Sharp and not so sharp arrowheads against fabric. 160 pound equivalent, 85 gram arrow, 192 feet per second, 125 pound equivalent, 65 gram arrow. 193 feet per second. 80 pound equivalent, 65 gram arrow. 155 feet per second. I'm down on the range now with my Type 16 bladed heads. Not super sharp, but not super blunt. Then I've got two layers of gambeson here. I want to highlight any differences between a blunt and a sharp head, a really sharp head. So that's why I've got the two layers. Bit of insulation foam, bit of plywood. It's time to go shoot some stuff. 80 pound longbow equivalent. Ah, interesting. Okay. Right, that is interesting. Now that is really interesting actually, because from the sound, I thought it was hitting the backboard. It wasn't hitting the backboard. Look at that. It's in. 25 millimeters, 1 inch. One of them bounced out. 20 millimeters, 3/4 inch. So when they're not super sharp, this defeats them. 125 pound longbow equivalent. Well, certainly in. Oh, just in, I think. Yes. Okay, good. Let's go check that out. Well, here's a little bit of a story. So this one just clipped it, basically didn't. And we've got 10 centimeters, 4 inches sticking out the back. This was the first one I did, has not penetrated the backboard. So that is marked depth of 15 centimeters, 6 inches. This one, the head is still poking out, you can see. So this one, it's pretty marginal about it going through. I'm going to add a bit here. by complete chance, and chance is what happens when 500,000 arrows get thrown at you, that has gone through a previous cut hole from a previous bladed head. So actually that one's not really a true sample. We're going to shoot one more of those. It's in, but I think we can tell, not that much. And yep, sure enough, still got 10 mil of the head sticking out. Actually, as is the nature, you're gonna have to take my word for it. You can see here, I've got to cut it out with a knife. Fabric armour for you. We have our original lockdown longbow, the 160 pound longbow equivalent. Nice, well it's in, it's in. Again. And again. Right, let's go see what we got. So here we are with our three. I can tell immediately they're not into the wood. This one's got a depth of about 7 centimetres on it. Can't turn that one, but it looks to be a little bit more. That's about 9. And this one is about 10 centimetres. So that's the deepest of them, and it is just about touching the wood, I would think. But let's pull them. We'll sharpen them up, proper sharp, and we'll do the test again. I stopped filming and then I pulled it off the foam, but I've got to show you this. So there we are. That is the penetration from our biggest bow through the back. So this one here, to give you a sense of scale, 3/4 inch, 20 millimeters. This one, 2 inches, 55 millimeters, about that. I'm back now with all of my sharpened heads. Now they're not razor sharp, but they are sort of kitchen knife sharp. You know, you're not going to want to run your hands over them, but you're not going to shave my hairy beard off with them. I chose that kind of level of sharpness deliberately, actually, because I think once you buy 100,000 of these, they'll be transported all the way across Europe, into France, whatever, they're not going to end up being razors. But they're not also going to be just straight off the anvil, pretty much as I thought they were. I think they're going to be a bit better than that, and we're about to find out. But before we do that, time for another shameless ad, I'm afraid. Todd's Workshop crossbows. They're available on the in-stock page on toddsworkshop.com. This one is a 350 pound draw weight munition grade crossbow. So basically it's for soldiers. You know, it's fairly basic, fairly simple, fairly straightforward, but 350 pounds, it packs a punch. Need to span it with a goat's foot lever because you ain't gonna do it by hand. Even the infamous Eddie Hall, I'm thinking, maybe he could. Anyway, comes back. Pretty easy, really. And then it shoots these big, chunky bits of wood and steel. Packs a punch. Right, we're back after that word from our sponsors. Sharp arrowheads, properly sharp, and the weakest of our bows. It's in. Doesn't look very deep, though. Just off. I've pulled the one that went off because something interesting has happened and I want to do that third shot. I want to get it in. It's in. Let's go have a look. Now, something interesting has happened here. This is not amazing science. It's a sample size of 3. But here we go. This one here, the socket is just covered by the gambeson. Before, all the sockets had about 1 centimetre exposed. These two, though, very different story. So this one is in about 13 centimetres and this one in about 9 centimetres. Very, very different. Don't forget, this gambeson turned the arrowheads before. Now they're going through. Sharp does matter. Those are mortal wounds at that depth. 125 pound equivalent. It's in, but it doesn't look deep. Oh, just over. And in. We'll do the miss again, I think. Yeah, and in. Good. Shall we see what we got? So these two are both in at about 15. This one is in at about 9, but I guess maybe there's a difference, you know, between sharp and what you think is sharp. But anyway, either way, definitely, definitely deeper because they weren't really penetrating off this bow before. So we'll have a look at the big one. And now for the last of our bows, 160 pound equivalent. With properly sharp arrows. It's in. Right, all three in. Let's go see what we have. And here we have our three arrows, properly sharp this time. And they've gone in 15, 16 centimetres as opposed to 10 centimetres or less. But also, they've gone through that 12 millimetre, half inch strand board, sort of cheap plywood stuff. And they're sticking out about so far out the backside. So an inch, 2.5 centimetres, something like that. A very significant difference. It really does count. There's one more test I have to do for my own curiosity. Those arrows were clean. There was no wax on them, no grease on them, because I didn't want that kind of variable in there. I've greased this one up, bit of wax on the head. Let's just see what it does, because earlier films showed it penetrated better. Well, it's in, no surprise. I wanted to try this because I thought it would make a significant difference. My earlier films showed against shields and things it did. Against this target, it hasn't. 17 centimetres, 15 centimetres before. Not that exciting. Back at base now to have a think about what we've learnt. And the first thing is, sharpening your arrowheads matters. And I feel so very, very foolish right about now for not thinking it mattered that much. But it really did. So it turned, I can't explain my thinking, it turned the light bow, the 80-pound bow, into giving you a pinprick to, let's go see the surgeon. And it turned the heavy one from, you know, reasonable penetration, probably going to kill you, to that much more. It counts. But, oh, sorry, that much more also through 12mm, half inch of wood. So it really, really matters. That's important. I learned that. The other thing is the gambeson. What that means is if your sharp arrowhead meets the gambeson sharp, it will go through. But then we come to the armour, because the armour is a composite system. It is maille and it is padding, gambeson. Do you wear the maille over the top or underneath? Well, that is going to be the subject of the next film, because I think it's going to make a difference. But the last thing I'd like to consider is the gambeson itself and the role that that played. Now, I think one layer that I had here, which is what, 11, 12 millimetres thick, something like that. 5.8 kilos for a full-size garment. You could wear that. You can wear that in conjunction with maille. But if you don't have maille, you could make it thicker because you can carry more weight, of course. So that would take it up, if you doubled it, like I was today, to about maybe 10 or 11 kilos for that garment, for the whole gambeson. That is going to afford you very good protection. Because also don't forget that I took great care to sharpen those arrowheads, but also the distance I was shooting at was only about 20, 22 metres. Now, we know from distance tests that I've done as well, previous film, check it out, that out at 100 metres, we're losing quite a lot of velocity. I can't remember what it was now, but it was like 12% or something. That might be enough to save your life. So basically, even if you can't afford maille, a heavyweight gambeson, make it proper, make it thick, and it is resistant to incredibly powerful bows, even with cutting edge arrows. Cutting edge? Arrows with cutting edges. Anyway, been a bit of a long one this time. I hope you enjoyed it, but I'll catch you next time for gambesons and maille and sharpened arrowheads. Do you wear the gambeson under the maille or over the maille? Let's find out.